Welcome to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast, your guide in the race to financial freedom through real estate investing and sound financial practices. This podcast is for anyone interested in learning more about real estate investing, personal finances, and a new take on traditional retirement. Now, here are your hosts, Larry Fierro and Mike Moe.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast, your Monday morning motivation edition, where we follow up on our call to action from the previous episode. We hit you with a little motivation to start your Monday morning off right. And then, my friend, Mr. Fierro, we tee up the episode to come, which we got some good guests the last handful of the weeks and months that we've started rolling out these interviews a little bit more hot and heavy. So, you know, per usual, I'm excited about this episode to come and what our guest is going to share with our listeners.
The guests have been bringing the knowledge, man. They're providing so much value for our listeners and us. I mean, I've been paying real close attention to what they've been saying, and it's drastically affected how I look at my own investing career. So
yeah,
hopefully everybody's taking notes and keeping track of what's going on, because it's a lot.
Yeah, for sure, man. You have tons of good things our guests are bringing to listeners, and yeah, it's great to start to figure out how you can implement, man. That's the whole point of this thing. Is we don't want to just provide knowledge to go in one ear and out the other. We want you guys to be actually implementing some of these really golden nuggets that our guests have learned from years and years of experience, and oftentimes a ton of failures and mistakes that they've gone through. You know, is how they've learned. So yeah, definitely make sure you're implementing and taking action on this, because it's, in my perspective, as I'm the same thing with you. I'm listening to these guests and just finding huge improvements and efficiencies in my own investing.
Perfect. And that's what the whole podcast is about, man.
Heck yeah.
Helping everybody. So call to action from last week. You want to jump on that?
Yeah, for sure, man. Mr. Murdoch, you know, in the theme of dropping huge knowledge bombs and just adding a ton of value, you know, we talked to Mr. Murdoch about how he started with a duplex and, you know, he's now got $42 million under contract with Open Door Capital. So one of the things that stuck out really to me in this interview was how many times Ryan had to take a step back to take two steps forward. And it was clear in when he left his position in the manufacturing role, when he basically signed up to be an executive assistant for Brandon Turner from Bigger Pockets. He left his brokerage, he left what he was doing on the East Coast and did that knowing what it could do for him in the future. So the call to action was, look at these spots in your life, look at these spots in your business. Where do you need to scale it back in order to take that step forward, to really propel you forward? And you got to put the ego aside. You got to, a lot of people don't want to take that step back because they don't see, it's a little bit short-sighted. They don't see kind of what it could do for them in the long run, but you got to do it sometimes.
Sometimes you just have to step back and take a wider view of your life and what's going on and see if it's exactly what you want. And
yeah,
I guarantee you won't be upset if you end up having to make a change, because I'm living proof you can do it.
Yeah, absolutely. So cool.
Yeah. Today's Monday morning motivation, man. It's Monday morning. It's a new week, clean slate, I like to call it. So what do we got going on today?
Talking about self-sufficiency, man. Talking about really, if you guys are doing something, you have to make sure that you're accountable to yourself and that you are being the driving force of getting to your goals, because nobody's going to come in and take care of you and hand things care of you, you know, 20, 30 years from now when you're looking at 62 or 65 or, you know, and looking for starting then. You need to start now and making sure that you're self-sufficient and planning it accordingly.
And I'm going to quote a cliche right now. You know, my grandfather used to say when I was younger, if you're looking for somebody to care about your financial health as much as you do, then you're wasting your time. You guys have to pay attention to your own success, your own financial future, and not wait for that person to ride up on the white horse, you know, with the hair flowing or whatever, and just hand you a giant $2 million check, because that's not happening.
No,
if that's
no.
What you're waiting for, you in trouble.
Yeah. And that's what I love about the real estate in the entrepreneur industry, is there's just so, like, that mindset is so prevalent throughout this. People who are like taking control and taking action and really deciding on it and not waiting for somebody to come and save them in 20 or 30 years when they're ready to retire. So it's really cool to see as we talk to these various people throughout the industry and how they're doing it. So
yeah, and as you know, with retirement plans and Social Security and that sort of thing, you just don't know. You don't know if it'll be there by the time you retire. And if you're putting all your eggs in that basket, then you really could get caught short. So today, right now, you need to start looking at self-sufficiency and making sure that you're covering your own basis as far as getting retired, getting the life that you want, and listening to the Real Estate Marathon podcast is a big part of that, because we're trying to help get you to financial freedom, and we're showing you the path on how to take action. And you, all you got to do is just go back and re-listen to some of our episodes and start following our advice, because we've gone down the road before you.
Yeah. And it starts with education, right? So if you, if you're one of those folks who are working a role right now and just shoving a couple percent into a 401k and hoping that in 30 years, that's going to be enough. Do you know that? Like, do you know that's going to be enough? Have you educated yourself on knowing what you're putting in, what the average returns are, what you'd like to live in retirement? And just, you have to be educated about what you're doing. You have to have a plan just so you're not moseying through the next 30 years and hoping that there's going to be enough there. So if you do your research and you get your education and you decide that's still the route you go, but maybe you tweak it to make sure that it meets your goals, then perfect. We're not saying real estate is like the only way to do it, but we're saying you need to understand what you're doing to make sure that you're not going to be surprised in 20 or 30 years.
And track it closely, because it can go from being healthy to real bad shape in a blink of an eye. So,
or if you want to retire in a lot less time than 20 or 30 years than the typical American, we've talked about that tons and tons of times on the show, that the retirement's, it's not an age, it's a number. It's purely a cash flow in and cash flow out situation. So it's definitely not an age. It could be 25 instead of 65. It all depends on what you're doing and what your goals are and how quickly you can take action.
And it's funny you should say that. As soon as we're done recording this, I'm going camping.
Heck yeah.
So, and Thursday's episode, dude, love this episode coming up, man.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's a good one, man. It's with Mr. Will Coleman, Director of Finance over at Rand Capital. And as we discussed a little bit in the show, I met Will, I think about a year ago now. We were at an event in Atlanta, and we shared a cab back to the airport, and then both of our flights got delayed. So we ended up having a beer or two in the airport. And dude, I was impressed with that dude back then and how sharp and how smart he was with what he was doing in real estate. And even more so now that he's, what he's doing from a financing perspective. So really excited to get into this one.
Oh yeah. He just brought so much knowledge.
Yeah.
It was phenomenal. So,
So we're going to talk to him about financing your first deal and the ins and outs of commercial financing and some of those differences between what you might see in like a 1-4 and what you're going to see in a 5 and up from a financing perspective. So,
Perfect. Perfect. Yeah. You're going to want to re-listen to it 2 or 3 times too, because nuggets that you'll catch every time.
Absolutely. So cool, man.
Well, dude, that's it for me. Just make sure you guys are making the best of your week and keep staying on that path to self-sufficiency.
Heck yeah, man. All right. Thank you guys for tuning in to another episode of the Real Estate Marathon Podcast. We'll see you next time.
Take care.
Thanks for listening to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast. If you found value in any of the content from this show, consider supporting us in the following ways. Subscribe to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast. Leave a rating and review. Continue the conversation with like-minded individuals on social media by heading over to the Real Estate Marathon Podcast Facebook group, or follow us on Instagram and Twitter @Real Estate Marathon Podcast.